Hi everyone. I wanted to point out a few differences between this motorized version and the non-motorized version of this walker. The first, obviously, is the motorized version has a longer leg base to give it more stability than this non-motorized version. And I did it by spacing the two cranks, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 holes in between so the cranks don't collide. Second minor difference is this non-motorized version used rubber tires for feet to give it traction. The motorized legs drag a little bit, and so I didn't use rubber because that could disrupt the gait if the rubber caught. Instead, I used these quarter circle parts, which don't have the same grip, and I added these rubber bands, which give it a little bit more foot contact for each crank rotation and a little more stability. Third thing that is not as obvious is the timing of the front and rear legs. For these quadrupeds, you typically want, for a stable quadruped, you typically want the two corners in contact, and you keep switching from this to that to this to that. And how you do that is you put the left and right sides 180 degrees out of phase, as well as the front and back. But to get, when the walker's frame connections are not at the same height as the main axle, having them share the same phase of the crank will not put them 180 degrees out of phase. Instead, what you want to do is you want to have the front axle pointing at its frame connection with the rear axle pointing away from its frame connection. Okay, that puts the front and rear legs 180 degrees out of phase, and I'll turn it on so we can see it in action. Okay, hope that helps. Oh, finally, of course, the major difference is the motor and the transmission. And in this case, I used Hero Labo's compact transmission. Made a few modifications, but in general, I just followed his plan. And I'll put some directions together to show how I modified what Hero Labo did. Thanks so much for that, Hero. Okay, bye.